So today we will discuss the effects of expansionary monetary policy in the simultaneous equilibrium of commodity and money markets. So let us consider the expansionary monetary policy, that means increasing money supply. So money supply can be increased in different ways. There are different instruments of expansionary monetary policy. One is the increase in money supply by printing new notes, currencies, and circulate it. It can be done by the open market operation by the central bank, through which the central bank purchases the bonds from the open market and money is injected. Besides that, the commercial banks are also asked to increase their credit creation. So whatever it is, it will inject the more money into the system. So there will be an increase in M bar by P. So now we will explain the effects of increase in money supply in ISLM framework. So what happens? Let us start with the situation when the product market and money market both are in equilibrium. So if we start, that money supply increases. So whenever money supply increases, the supply of money will be greater than demand for money. Money supply will be greater than money demand. So it will cause an excess demand situation, an excess supply situation in the money market. So excess supply in money market will be automatically, whenever people will have more money in their hand, they will try to purchase bonds to get rid of the extra money. They will start to purchase the bonds. So there will be excess demand in the bond market, and consequently the bond price will start to rise. So whenever bond price starts to rise, the rate of interest will start to fall again, and it has two impacts. Number one, the demand for idle cash will increase in the hand, or demand for liquidity, and on the other hand, the private investment will boost up the private investment, and private investment boost up means the aggregate demand will also increase. So this process will be continued unless the money market equilibrium is restored again. So the effect of monetary policy can be represented with the help of this diagram. So this is your IS curve, I0, S0. This is R0, Y0. So what do you see? That now at this Y0 there is, the money market is in equilibrium, but product market is not in equilibrium. So what you will see, the rate of interest will start to fall, and the rate of interest will still, there will be excess supply situation in the money market, rate of interest will start to fall, and private investment will start to rise. So equilibrium will be R1, Y1. So E0, so what is this LM curve? Initially L0, M0 is the LM curve. So whenever there is there is a rising increase in money supply, the LM curve, they will get a new LM curve L1, M1 and new equilibrium point E1. So movement from E0 to E1 takes place here, Y0 to Y1 takes place here due to rise in private investment caused by a decline in money rate of interest. So rate of interest declines, output level will increase. In vertical axis we are measuring rate of interest, in horizontal axis we are measuring Y. So now we will consider the case of money multiplier. So let us consider the equilibrium conditions in commodity and money market. So commodity market equilibrium, Y equals to A plus BY plus IR plus G. I dash is less than 0 and this is the money market condition, KY plus LR equals to M bar by P when K dash greater than 0, L dash less than 0. So this is equation number 1 and 2. We will differentiate both. If we differentiate 1, we will get dy into p dy plus I dash dr. Here government expenditure is constant, so it will be 0. So we can write here dy into 1 minus b minus I dash dr equals to 0. This is 1a. And if we differentiate 2, we will get K dash into dy plus L dash into dr equals to B m bar by P. This is 2a. So now if we represent 1a and 2a in the matrix multiplication form, we will get one minus b minus I dash k dash l dash zero b of b m bar by p. So this system can be solved if we find the determinant value of this, the coefficient is not equals to 0. So if delta not equals to 0, so delta equals to what you see, 1 minus b minus I dash k dash l dash equals to, you can do it, l dash into 1 minus b plus I dash k dash, and we know that l dash is less than 0, I dash is less than 0, that implies delta will be not equal to 0 or delta is less than 0. This problem can be solved. So now we will find, try to solve the value of dy by using Cramer's rule. So in Cramer's rule, dy equals to 1 by delta multiplied by 0 dm bar by p and minus I dash l dash, or dy equals to 1 by delta into dm bar by p into I dash, or the money multiplier dy by dm bar by p equals to I dash divided by 1 minus b l dash into 1 minus b plus I dash into k dash, or equals to 1 divided by L dash by K dash 1 minus B plus, sorry, L dash will be L dash by I dash plus K dash. Now let us find the value of it. L dash is less than 0, I dash less than 0, so it will be positive. 1 minus b positive, a dash positive. So we can write here that dy by dm bar by p, this is positive. So if the money supply increases, that will increase the level of aggregate demand and output. The mechanism is simple. If money supply increases in the money market, the rate of interest will fall, and if rate of interest falls, that will boost up the private investment, and private investment is a part of aggregate demand. And second thing we can say, the effectiveness of monetary policy depends upon two things, L dash and I dash, because K dash is constant exogenously given and B is exogenously given. So let us consider L dash and I dash. L dash is what? L dash is the interest sensitivity of speculative demand for money, and I dash is the interest sensitivity of private investment. So here we can see, higher the value of I dash, higher the value of the multiplier. Why? Because what happens in rate of, if money supply increases, rate of interest falls. So if interest sensitivity of private investment is high, a small decline in rate of interest will create a huge rise in private investment, and the effect of monetary policy will be higher. Similarly, monetary policy is inversely related to the interest sensitivity of the demand for money. What is this? Why? Because in this case, if we say that the money supply increases, if interest sensitivity of demand for money is high, a small decline in rate of interest will restore the equilibrium. So if the decline in rate of interest is small, it will have also less effect on private investment and aggregate demand. So we can say here, higher the interest sensitivity of private investment, higher will be the effectiveness of monetary policy, higher will be the value of money multiplier, and higher the interest sensitivity of speculative demand for money, less will be the effectiveness of monetary policy, or less will be the value of money multiplier.